across the country are going to start writing their primary leaving examinations. We just had a report coming in from Kampala as schools are prepared amid actually Ebola outbreak in the country. Now we just want to understand what exactly is taking place on the ground in the two districts of Mubende and Kasanda, how schools are prepared and how students are faring with this whole situation, sitting for an examination in a district or in an area that has been placed under a lockdown. Over the weekend, we saw the government extending the 21 days after the other past 21 days elapsed. Now we want to actually, we'll be talking to three distinguished guests, but they will be joining us live from Kasanda and from Mubende districts. That's our journalist here, Luke Kajiri, will be joining us on the show, but also Drake Sembus is the Secretary for Education and Health in Kasanda District, and also Haji Rukoya Sekabira, a District Education Officer in Kasanda District. They are all live from those two districts. I want to start with Haji Rukoya Sekabira. A very good morning, Haji, and welcome to Rush Hour. Please brief us what exactly is the situation in Kasanda and probably in the neighboring district of Mubende.
Good morning, viewers. I'm Haji Sekabira Abdul Lugoya. I'm the District Education Officer at Kasanda. Right now, we are in preparation for our candidate who registered for primary living examinations, which is yet to begin tomorrow. But right now, we are eagerly waiting for the script to be delivered to the district. We have already made the arrangements for our scouts, the invigilators, and the supervisors. The candidates are already prepared to sit for their primary living examination.
We understand.
Challenges, though we have got some challenges, our viewers, you know very well that in Kasanda and Mubende, we are under a lockdown, but we are trying our level best to see that we have got genuine and, genuine and successful primary living examination exercise. Right now, I thank the government of Uganda, in particular, the Ministry of Education and Sport, with our partners, UNICEF, who have provided us with transport, because you know that Kasanda, we are under total lockdown, whereby we don't have public means of transport, which are in operational. But as we see, we have got the arrangement. These partners, they have sent us 15 vans, which are going to be used to transport the scouts, invigilators, supervisors, and the candidates from their homes to the sitting centers. We are very gratitude.
You were talking about 15 vans and the reports that
vans.
We had, 16 vans. And,
15,
and the reports,
15.
15. And the report that we are getting from the ministry shows that about over 800,000 students are going to be sitting for these examinations. How many candidates do you have?
Kasanda, we have got 5,230 candidates. We have got three constituencies, whereby Kasanda South constituency has got 5 vans, Kasanda North, 5, and also Bukuya constituency, 5 vans. The advantage is that under this lockdown, we advise our candidates, most especially for schools with some facilities, to have provisional boarding sections whereby these learners, the candidates have been accommodated to avoid daily movement and contamination. We advise them to stay at their schools. Those facilities have not been sufficient and of high standard, but we have managed to overcome that problem. So these are the supervisors, invigilators, and the scouts who would move in, plus a few candidates who were commuting from home. So even after the examinations, we are also provided with transport to help these learners to be taken back home with these vans. It will be very easy for us in case of anything, never know. It will be very easy to trace these learners because we have got their contacts, their homes, and so on.
Where are you picking, where are these vans supposed to pick these learners from? And
we have got
when are they supposed to be picked?
Each van has been assigned with an inspector of schools. For example, in Cassandra South, we have got Mr. Kwago Fran. Cassandra North, we have got Akman Waswa. And Bukuya constituency, Mr. Selvira Donia is coordinating. So we have got our WhatsApp group, whereby those in need who are ready for the transport, they call or they post there. We have got we have drafted the movement routes for these buses, and it is very easy for them to pick them from their schools. Now, those who are going to the centers, we have got converging centers, whereby we put provisional stages where the vans pick them and take them to their respective schools following those routes.
Where are they going to be picked from? And are they picked from their respective homes? Each student is picked from a home, or
No.
They're supposed to be picked.
They foot and come to the provisional stage where, which we have already established.
Now, you also talked about advising schools to actually keep these students for the 2 days they are going to be writing these examinations. Who is going to meet the cost of their accommodation, the cost of their meals, and the cost of their
The schools and the parents, they have that internal arrangement. You know, we are in a pandemic where we expect everybody to be cooperative because this is an experience which was not, you know, budgeted for and which is not called for. It just came. That came and we have got to abide with it. So these learners have not been in schools for this only for these 2 days. As we said that the pandemic, we had to reduce the contamination of our learners. That's why we don't have cases in schools. So we advise the candidate that they come stay in school so that they don't contaminate with the other people in the community. So the parents had to contribute for the food for their children. And good enough, some of the schools have, we are boarding schools. And we expect the learners to be just near the school more than the home. That's why we have not got any challenges with the feeding of these learners. Yes.
Haji Sekavira, just brief us. What measure have you put in place to ensure that children and pupils with special needs are given the necessary attention that they need, as opposed to the ones who are not in that category?
Learners with special needs, it is fortunate that we don't have many of the kind, especially with physical impairment. But these other impairments, they have been coping up with the situation as normally, as usual they have been doing. So we have not got any challenge with such.
We will actually get back to you. You can as well keep online. We have to engage the secretary for
education. We also thank UNICEF that
yes.
has provided us with the temperature gun.
We will get back to that point, Haj, later.
Thank you.
I just want to connect to Mr. Drake Sembus. He's the secretary for education and health in Cassandra district. We just want to find out the situation there. What exactly is taking place and what is the state of the pandemic, or rather of the Ebola outbreak in that district. A very good morning, Mr. Drake, and welcome to Rush Hour. Mr. Drake, are you there? We were supposed to be talking to Mr. Drake Asembus, he's the Secretary for Education and Health in Cassandra District, but also we want to also find out how is the arrangement in the public and how parents are prepared to take their children and their pupils to have to write these examinations, which are supposed to be kicking off tomorrow. Now we just want to also connect to our Vision Group reporter, Luke Kajiri. He's a reporter from that area of area Mitiana, Mubende, Chiboga, Chankwaza, and that area. We just want to find out what Luke is actually has have to say. But before we talk to Mr. Luke Kajiri, let's listen to, I'm told that Mr. Sembusi is already online. Drake Sembusi, a very good morning and welcome to Rush Hour.
Yes, good morning, Bwana Lima.
Please, we understand that Kasanda District is and Mubende District are under a lockdown.
Definitely.
What is, first of all, the situation on the ground in terms of the Ebola prevention of Ebola outbreak in that region, and how sure that our children and our pupils are going to be sitting for that examination without any problem?
Thank you very much, Bwana Lima. Dear viewers and listeners of this mighty media, my name is Sembusi Drake. I'm here at the District Secretary for Health, Kasanda District. As the question has been posed to me, the situation, I want to assure the viewers and listeners of this mighty media that our learners are going to their examination here in examinations without any inconveniences, because we have had enough of strategies to see that our learners are not disturbed while sitting their examinations. I therefore want to take this opportunity to extend my sincere thanks to UNICEF Uganda, because it has donated 15 vans to Kasanda District that are going to help us transport our learners to their various centers where they registered. They are going to for their examinations, and also the teachers and the vigilators to see that this activity goes on smoothly without any inconveniences. So we saw this, and the preparations are in high gear so that none of our learners misses their PLG examination.
How many cases so far do you have in Kasanda, and how are you ensuring that these children or these pupils, when they go to sit for these examinations, do not actually affect the others? Because some of them might be as well as, you know, they might be having Ebola, and they get to be mixed up in the students who are not affected.
Yes, as of today, it's now 3 days without registering any positive case, because we have a positive case on Thursday. And the cumulative number of positives are reported for Kasanda District. Those that are brought to their lives as a team, that is as of Thursday. As of today, we have not registered any other positive case. So, trying to ensure that none of our learners is affected, we are so vigilant. We trained contact tracers, we have trained our teachers and managers of schools, such that if at all any learner is identified with registered signs and symptoms, that learner is reported immediately. You have a toll-free number, and immediate action can be taken to evacuate that person, that learner, from the other students or learners. This person can be taken to the isolation center, tested, and identified the signs and symptoms are for Ebola. If not Ebola, then we can treat that learner to say that it's sure the other disease. As of today, we have not registered any positive case from schools. So we have handled the situation as of today.
So in other words, you were saying that there is no screening of pupils from their homes. Every child that leaves their home, they can as well go and sit an examination without any screening process taking place.
The screening that because more emphasis is put on community awareness, more so in schools and our sub counties, to make our community aware that we have Ebola. So, in case you identify anybody with signs and symptoms, please report immediately. We have intensified screening in schools, and also put coordinators. We identify a teacher, train that teacher in contact tracing, IPC, that is infection prevention and control, the words and the like. such that any case, any minor case that is just in proof and good process is made, such that you can curb this deadly disease from spreading over the learners. So we have got this, and it is not spreading anyway.
Yeah, but also we understand that although Ebola is the case today, also COVID-19 is still a problem in our country.
Definitely.
What measures have you put in place to ensure that the spread of COVID is also not actually seen in that area? Just, and you know, bearing in mind that the lockdown in those two districts were extended by government.
Yes, we are still following the SOP, the standard procedures for COVID. And the good thing, most of them align with the Ebola. Because when we talk of washing hands regularly, it is one of the SOPs for Ebola, and I mean for COVID, using our masks, because we know Ebola is transmitted through body fluids. Somebody may be speaking and spit out saliva, which saliva could be containing the virus. And remember, during the time of COVID, we intensified the wearing of masks because COVID is transmitted through the air, then Ebola is transmitted through body fluids. So you see that some of these, they move together. Wearing masks, washing hands, and the like, these things move together to prevent the two diseases, Ebola and COVID. So we are intensifying this and encouraging our communities to avoid sharing hands, shaking hands, those hearts, and the like, such that we can prevent the diseases and keep our community healthy.
The DEO has just told us that actually some of the schools have been advised to keep these pupils who are going to sit for PLE in schools for the 2 days they are going to be there.
Definitely.
What assurance would you give to the public that actually these students are going to be safe in that environment? And are you sure the schools have the facilities and the spaces where actually these pupils are going to be kept?
Yes, I want to assure the public that because we have Ebola in the district, we have a number of partners, government has deployed, taking coffee from, we have supervised each and every facility where our people are going to sit for their PhD exam. So I want to assure the public that these facilities are safe. We have supervised the latrine, the classroom, the distance is socially managed. We have gone for an extra mile of creating new centers, demolishing those that did not qualify and then have new centers that are more safe where our learners can for the examination.
What do you mean by new centers? Which centers? For what purpose?
The UNEB center.
Oh.
We engage the UNEB. So some of these seating centers that were not up to standard, we're stopped, and then we have some four new centers where our learners can sit for their examination and when they are safe and healthy.
Mm.
Yes.
So where exactly, for example, these centers have been created? Are they not so far away from the schools, or they have been put in nearby places where these schools can as well be enriched?
They are within. They are within. They are accessible. I will consider all white looking at the proximity. And the good thing is that we will have transport, free transport. As I earlier told you, that the UNICEF provided us 15 vans who have mapped out routes. And I want to assure the community that none of our learners is going to miss out.
Thank you so much, Mr. Drake Sembu, Secretary for Education and Health in Kasanda District. We've been talking to him, and of course, he's bringing to us a picture of what exactly is taking place in the district of Kasanda. Remember, those two districts were placed under the lockdown together with the Mubende District, and over the weekend, government extended this lockdown in those two districts for more 21 days. But of course, we have assurance from UNEB that all the students from those two districts will be sitting for those examinations, which are supposed to be starting off tomorrow. Now, we just want to take a short break, but before we do that, There is the Minister for Health, that's Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, is having a lot of message to tell you regarding the students who are going to sit for examinations and the situation in both Kasanda and Mubende district. Then we'll be coming back with our Vision Group reporter who is on the ground.
The 21 days elapsed yesterday, Friday, the 4th November, 2021. The National Task Force sat yesterday to evaluate the situation in the two districts as well as Kampala metropolitan area. His Excellency the President directed that I update the country. I will now report on the decisions as directed by His Excellency the President. The outbreak has affected the districts of Mubende, Kasanda, Kagadi, Unyangabo, Chegegwa, Wakiso, Kampala City, and most recently, Masaka District. This brings the total number of affected authorities and local governments to 8. This spread is attributed to movements of contacts and symptomatic individuals for health services. Regarding the status of the Ebola outbreak, to date, a total of 132 people have been confirmed positive for Ebola virus disease. 61 have recovered, while 53 have succumbed to the disease. A total of 18 confirmed cases are still admitted, receiving treatment at both Mubende and Entebbe Ebola treatment units. The outbreak epicenter remains Mubende and Kasanda districts. To minimize further spread of Ebola within these districts and to protect the rest of the country from continued exposure, all the directives issued by His Excellency the President of Uganda on the 15th of October 2022 will be extended for another 21 days. Additionally, all private healthcare facilities and drug shops in Mubende and Kasanda will be inspected and assessed for conformity with infection prevention and control standards.
Welcome to The Big Issue. My name is Mubarak Mugabu. Now we want to actually also go back to Kasanda District and Mubende Districts, which were placed under a lockdown 21 days when actually restricted public transport in there. But also, we also understand that the examinations are for primary leaving examinations, pupils of primary 7 are supposed to be taking off tomorrow. And we have been just speaking to the district education officer and also the secretary for health of Kasanda District, and they have given us an account of what exactly is taking place there. They have been given some vans from UNICEF, and they will be actually taking those students and pupils to sit for these examinations. Now we want to find out what our Vision Group reporter Luke Kajiri has for us this morning and to paint for us a picture of what exactly is taking place in Kasanda and how parents and students are prepared for this examination. A very good morning, Luke, and welcome to Rush Hour. Hello, Luke. Hello, do you hear me, Luke?
Yes, please.
Very good morning. And we just want to actually to just please paint for us a picture of what exactly is happening in Kasanda and Mubende and maybe the neighboring districts of how pupils and parents and teachers and schools are prepared for the PLE examinations.
All right. Thank you very much. And good morning to our viewers. And thank you for tuning to Urban TV. The situation here, as in the school, the people preparing for PLE, is not quite so good. And actually, if you analyze more, it is even worse. Because first of all, since the lockdown started, the major problem has been transport.
Yes.
And this caused many people to suffer. It caused very negative effects to the pupils that many teachers have even been missing in school. I was listening to Mr. Drake and the BEO, and they were telling us that the pupils are going to sit for exams without any inconveniences. But I think it isn't. We only need players to see that these people sit for PLE comfortably. You find that although they are providing transport, you cannot be sure where this transport will be reliable and these people can be carried well to the particular schools or not. Because first of all, before the open started, when they bought these vehicles, civil servants had been supposed to be using them to go to their places of work. But many have been missed. Mostly, the teachers have not been in school, that they have been running this sort of new vision group platform. And the complaint has been going. People have raised it to different officials, different institutions, and no answer. One time I was talking to the certain officer, UPDF officer, who is the fleet manager. I was telling him why are these people not being answered? There is a general complaint about the means of transport, and nothing could be done. So I'm still wondering, today I'm yet to move around and see, but I'm still wondering how these pupils are going to be carried to the particular schools, then brought back to their homes. Because already the system has failed. Either these civil servants have maybe been just refusing to board the vehicles, or the system was not arranged well. That is one.
Have you interacted with parents before we get to this day of how they are prepared to take their children to school, and what was their reaction?
Parents of the candidates or all the parents?
All the parents generally.
Generally, all the parents have different reactions about the situation. I've talked to some of them, but the parents who the candidates are just worried, wondering how these 2 days are going to be held. Then others are just worrying on what is next after the lockdown. Because in most of the schools, the situation changed. Like I told you, when teachers started missing, it was like schools almost were closed. Mr. Drake, VEO have been moving around, and themselves, they know the problem. They have tried to raise it somewhere, and they have tried to advise the teachers use these means of transport, but still some are refusing. So that is a very great challenge to the education sector in these districts. And if you move around, you actually see many pupils walking around the villages in school-going time. That means some of these pupils have dropped out because of the situation. Much as these pupils have been told to stay there for PLE, someone can still wonder how they are going to stay there. Because most of these schools have very poor facilities.
And some of them are day schools, certainly.
Most of them are day schools with poor facilities. Now they are trying to force ends meet, put in their dormitories to accommodate these pupils, which is a little bit challenging.
Is the situation in Kasanda and Mubende, are they different? And how are they different with the surrounding districts of Mityana, Chivoga, Chankwanza, and around there?
First of all, Kasanda is kind of, it may sound well, but Kasanda is kind of a rural area. This is the part with a district which was carved off Mubende. It's kind of a rural area, a rural setting. Mm. Mubende is kind of developing, but still some sub-counties in a rural setting. So the situation is kind of different, but not so different. Almost in most of the villages, it is even almost the same. Apart from Mitiana, Mitiana is quite different from these two districts. Because some of the schools are not so poor, although still having poor facilities. And the environment there in the village is also not so good.
Is there a feeling of panic, for example, for candidates or for parents or for students on how they are going to handle these examinations tomorrow? Are you seeing any sense of panic among the students or the pupils or the parents in regarding actually preparations for tomorrow's examinations?
It's too late. We had, when the lockdown started, all parents, teachers, education officers, and everybody, and all the development partners, we have NGOs here which are referred to as the development partners, like you are mentioning UNICEF, which is supporting them. Mm. All of them had to come together, teach and decide, discuss on how to help, on how to handle the candidates. But this was not done. Now what is supposed to be done, I think, today is one. They have to meet all those candidates, talk to them. As they get a briefing, these candidates need to be cancelled because some of them are already traumatized. They are being carried in these vehicles. These vehicles have already been named the Ebola vehicles in the villages. Some people are calling them Ebola vehicles. Some people don't like them. Now there are vehicles carrying the candidates. The candidates are being taken to facilities which are poor and being forced to stay there. Yes, they have to. So they have to be cancelled and so that they sit the exams well. All areas, they may fail even to write the papers well. Or they write and fail because of what they are feeling in their head and their heart.
Thank you, Luke. But before actually I let you go, what is the situation besides the PLE and the examination situation? What is the situation on ground in Kasanda? Are people going, how are they handling business without public transport? How is the situation generally, even in other schools and in other environments besides the primary 7 leaving examinations?
By now, the situation is coming back to normal. The first days in the lockdown were so bad, but when they allowed the motorcycles, the boda-boda motorcycles to carry luggage, at least we got some kind of relaxation and some businesses resumed. But in the first days, some businesses were all closing down because of the means of transport. It was a major challenge. And that was even affecting the nearby districts like Mitiana. Like I told you before, Kasanda is kind of a rural area. So Mitiana, in one way or another, depends on Kasanda. Like most of the food being consumed in Mitiana is got from Kasanda. So the effects were even going beyond the district. But right now, the situation is changing. People are getting back to their businesses. Although, in some areas, there is still fear. Some more people are now getting to know and understand that Ebola is there and is very dangerous. So I think actually the district leaders, they have gone around teaching people, training, giving them skills and all of that. And I think the awareness is making some good changes.
Yeah, so in other words, public transport, by allowing border borders, it somehow eased the tensions in that district, right?
Yeah, the border border at least is making some good change. Although they are carrying only luggage, but at least...
Yeah, at least some tensions are now back.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Luke, for that wonderful report. Of course, we'll be keeping interacting with you later and in our subsequent programming. That has been Luke Kajiri,
our
New Vision and Vision Group reporter are based in the districts of Mityana, Mubende, and Kasanda. We've been able to speak to Haji Rukoya Sekavira, the district education officer for Kasanda District. Luka Kajiri is the Vision Group reporter from that area, and also Drake Sembusi, Secretary for Health in Kasanda District. We've been trying to assess the situation of Ebola outbreak in those two districts, and also how schools and, you know, leaders are prepared to ensure that pupils can as well sit for their primary leaving examinations tomorrow. My name is Mubarak Mugabo. Thank you so much for keeping it urban. We are going to take a very short break. When we return, Rush Talk comes up.